Welcome back to the second part of Behind Escape. This time I'm playing the ninth escape map I made for Grena and will explain you some things that are going on behind the scenes and how they work. This is the second one made in vanilla and that's why it's also the second part of the series. We'll just start and you can already see this time we have a new countdown which DS made and we start out here in this tent. The theme this time is end. And if you want to see how the countdown works, I will just put it on screen now. So, at first we actually need to go to the end, and for that we need to solve some puzzles outside, well, in this area here. Here you can see a custom chest, that's actually quite simple. I have a chest, an actual chest inside here, you can see that this is not the actual hitbox, and that one is invisible. And then there's just a model of this big chest in the same place as the normal chest that was retextured to be invisible. And now I can go over here and break this gravel. And we can proceed. Then we can find some info here. Redstone torch, torch, and redstone torch is what matters. And that's a code that we need to enter back here. There's several levers that just change the torch, and there's not much going on, it just does a set block command to change the torch to the other torch. And then this gate opens. Now this happens, and suddenly I can't move anymore, but at some point you'll probably notice that you can still jump, and that's how you need to proceed here. I simply jump over here, and once I get the key, the curse goes away again. And finally, with this key, I can enter the stronghold. Now, we can't proceed in this room, but it tells us not everything you see is truly there, and that means we can walk through this. How I did this is, there's a block up here, and this block up here is actually the size of two blocks, so it's this and this block, and there's a block in the floor which is also the size of two blocks, and it's this bookshelf you see there. Because blocks can go one block further in each direction, this is possible. So it's just a simple model. And now this chest this door opens. In this room I need to find several eyes of Ender. The first one is behind this parkour, which I of course can't do. And I finally did it, and there's a second ender. When I fall into the lava, it simply detects if I'm in lava and then instantly teleports me back. And the third one is here, and a final one is over here. I can put them into this end portal, and with a score that checks whether I use Eyes of Ender, it detects, well, it's a scoreboard that just increases every time I use an Eye of Ender, and once that hits 4, it will teleport me over here. Here we have another code of colors, cyan, purple and orange, and those weird silverfish, and every time I hit them, they will teleport around. I simply check for the hurt time NBT tag, and if that is not 0, then it means they are hurt right now, and then I will teleport them to a different color. So this one is already correct. This one will either teleport to orange or yellow, because this one is one of them is for orange, well, yellow and red, the other one is cyan, blue and light blue, and the last one is purple, magenta and pink. So this one needs to go to cyan. And there we go. And here we see those flying blocks again that I already showed last time. And yeah, that's just an ender dragon. And technically only now I'm escaping from somewhere, because previously I was just entering the end. So here I can get a bow, And then I need to do a shulker box jump again. And this would of course be easier with two players, but I'm playing alone again. Then there's a button up here, which opens this. And then in this room I can go up here. And the two things here, chest. Didn't I just say the chests are invisible? Yes, I did, but this is actually a trap chest. And a button here. So now there's a hopper below the enchanting table, so if I throw the book on it, it will detect the book and will open off this door. Then here I have those pushable magma blocks again that I also had in the last escape, or I basically have them in every escape right now. And with those I can go up here and also open the second half of this door. And this is the final puzzle. Each of those buttons changes the door. There are two invisible armor stands here, and they always have an air block, and the other four blocks are shulker boxes. And with those buttons I can change the position. This one moves them up and down, this one moves them left, and this one moves them right. Or it only moves one at a time, so it's not entirely predictable. But if I do this, then it will open. This one is especially important because it determines the height. If they are both at the same Y level, then I can't possibly create a door. And that's already it. So thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments as always, and I will explain anything you want, how anything works in this map, and see you next time.